Hello, it's Shackleton and Paul Beckwith here. One of the fundamental questions that we have is, you know, that people have, both individually and collectively, is why do we live where we do? Partly it's due to climate. You know, there's different ecological niches or environmental niches, if you like, that are most conducive to people living and growing food. You know, often we live, you know, lots of people stay and live where they were born. You know, there's an attachment to place. They lay down roots and friends and so on. You know, many, many people do move for jobs, but mostly it's within their own country. I think today there's about something like 250 million people live outside of their country of birth. Something like that. But, you know, of course, climate is changing extremely fast. Dry areas are becoming drier. Wet areas are becoming wetter. There's lots of hazards now, which there wasn't before. You know, the frequency, severity, and duration of extreme weather events like floods, you know, droughts and dryness of forests leading to fires, etc. You know, food supply, population densities changing. You know, all of these things. I mean, many of us have no choice as to where we live, right? The richer do, they can always move, but the poorer do not. You know, the poor have very low adaptive capacity. Even think of Hurricane Katrina, for example, or, you know, one of the big hurricanes when people have to evacuate out of cities. I mean, a lot of people don't even have the means to get out of the cities. Okay, so, you know, often people just have to make the most of, you know, where they are. So let me go into this paper. This recent paper came out, which discusses all of these sort of things. It looks at how the climate is changing in different parts of the world and what we can expect for humanity. So the paper is called The Future of the Human Climate Niche. So, and it's open source, so please have a look at it if you want the details. All species have an environmental niche, and despite technological advances, humans are unlikely to be an exception. So for millennia, for thousands of years, human populations have resided in the same narrow part of the climate envelope available on the globe, characterized by a major mode around 11 degrees Celsius to 15 degrees Celsius. Okay, that's mean annual temperature. And, you know, we grow our crops and we produce, raise livestock in largely the same conditions, the same optimum that's found for agriculture and non-agricultural economic output is pretty striking. But with business as usual climate change scenario, the RCP 8.5 scenario, the temperature niche that we occupy, the temperature niche is projected to shift more over the coming 50 years, and it's moved since 6,000 before present, so the last 6,000 years. Now, populations won't simply track the shift in climate, because there'll be adaptation of people in places. But without migration, about one third of the global population is projected to experience a mean annual temperature greater than 29 degrees Celsius. Presently on Earth, mean annual temperature of greater than 29 Celsius is only on 0.8% of the Earth's land surface, mostly in the Sahara. Okay, and this number, you know, As the shifts occur, many, many people will then be exposed to living in this area, which will then cover almost 20% of the globe. So let's have a look at the main results of this study. So here we go. Get the whole thing in. Okay, so this is the... this is showing the mean annual temperature is on the vertical axis
and mean annual precipitation in millimeters is on the horizontal axis. So this is where humans are now. We're distributed across the precipitation, and in terms of temperature, we're mostly in these narrow bands. Okay, humans 500 years before present are over here, you know, much more localized region of mean annual temperature and precipitation that were conducive to settlements. And then 6,000 years ago, it was a bit more spread out. Of course, population densities were much lower. All of these regions fit into the available niche. So this is the niche, is the conditions on the land areas of the Earth that run between this temperature, mean annual temperature range, and precipitation range. Okay, here's where crops are presently grown. So that intersects to where humans are now, where livestock is produced. That is very similar to where humans are now. And GDP, it's a little bit, it's very similar, but it's a little bit offset to slightly lower mean annual temperature. Now, so these curves all match up. Where we are now, the crops, the livestock, the GDP, it's not much different from the past. And this is soil fertility, is covering a much wider range, and net primary productivity is covering a wider range, and we're more focused into these ranges here. So these aren't the main factors that decide where we are. Okay, so that's what's happening here. And here's the change in mean annual temperature experienced by humans. So the key thing is this is where we are currently in the blue curve here, coming up here. Okay, so this is the mean annual temperature range and population density. So there's many of us living between this mean annual temperature of, you know, the 11 to 15, an average of about 13. And there's some of us living with a mean annual temperature higher, about 25. This is the people that are living under the monsoon-like conditions, for example, India. So we've got this curve here. This is the niche. This is the blue line here at current. Now, the modeling projects, you know, it looks at the temperature changes and precipitation changes on the surface of the Earth, on the land areas, and it projects by 2070 in the RCP 8.5 scenario that this will be the distribution. The population density will be like this. So there'll be still the two nodes. Now, the second node, because most of the population growth is occurring in hotter regions, that's why this curve here, that's why this node here becomes much higher than the node here. And this node shifts. So instead of being at 13 degrees, it's centered at closer to 19 or 20 degrees. So that represents an average shift of about 7.5 degrees Celsius warmer. And then this node here, the second node here, also shifts to the, you know, 28 degrees or so. Now, if you look at the temperature range here, this is this is the mean temperature experienced by a human being in different periods. Okay, this plot. So this is 6,000 years before present. This is two different models showing slightly different results, but you know, this one's cooler than this one. This is 500 years before present. Okay, this is the beginning of the Industrial Revolution, about 300 years before present, so about 1720 or so. And this is where we currently are, you know, in this temperature range, the bulk of people. And here's what the 2070, here's the average for 2070. So, you know, we're jumping way, way up here. Okay, if you take the mean of these curves, you're somewhere like this. You know, 25 degrees Celsius or so, way up here. So what it's showing is that the climate conditions are shifting outside of where humans like to be. Okay, so we like to be, you know, and it's interesting, you know, going back to this figure. I mean, there's not a lot of change here to here, and the main The reddish areas where most people like to congregate haven't changed much over time, over the last 6,000 years. And yet in the next 50 years, we're projecting a huge shift here in conditions for where people, the conditions that people will experience. So this temperature niche will shift more in the next 50 years than it has moved from 6,000 before present to now. Okay, some people will, you know, adapt and just stay where they are. Others will migrate. Without migration, about 1/3 of the global population will experience mean annual temperatures greater than 29 degrees Celsius, about up here. These conditions, mean annual temperatures greater than 29, are presently found in only 0.8% of the Earth's land surface, mostly in the Sahara. So let's have a look here. So this is the mean annual temperature. This is a business as usual climate scenario. This is the present mean annual temperature. And these, you know, dark areas here, mean annual temperature is greater than 29 Celsius, are restricted to the small dark areas right here in the Sahara region. Okay, these small areas. This is at present. In 2070, the conditions of mean annual temperature and precipitation changing bring these areas, these hatched areas, will have a mean annual temperature greater than 29 degrees Celsius. Okay, and that will affect 3.5 billion people are living in those regions. And this follows a scenario. This is SSP3. This is the population growth scenario. Okay, so a huge part of the Earth will suddenly be experiencing the conditions that we presently only experience in the middle of the Sahara Desert. Okay, this is obviously going to have huge implications. This is going to affect human health, livelihoods, food security, water supply, economic growth. You know, even looking at 2 degrees Celsius versus 1.5 degrees Celsius rise, that's an additional 300 million people exposed to unfavorable conditions. Now, some areas will improve, but that's only a short-term situation, for example, such as Canada. So this is the current map of the world, and this is suitability for people, you know, living, for people thriving, low suitability to higher suitability, and you get these regions here. But the point is, look at the shift from current to 2070. So basically, the areas that are decent now become less suitable, and the whole thing is shifting northward. This whole curve is shifting northward. These guys here are all shifting northward. And if you take the difference of the two curves, then these orange areas become less suitable to live in, and the green areas become more suitable to live in. Okay. These areas will become like sources of population migrating perhaps to greener areas to try to get maintain that temperature niche that people have been used to having. Okay, so basically this is getting at the gist of, you know, where do humans thrive in the past, now, and in the future. Okay, so, you know, soil fertility, net primary productivity are not the main factors. Okay, going back up here. Okay, people want to be in this mean annual temperature is the most important variable. And there hasn't been a lot of change in the last 6,000 years. But in the next 50 years, we're shooting out of this range here into a very, very different planet. An average increase of about 7.5 degrees Celsius. So thank you for listening.